See, last what we discussed means how to write the a plus b, how to a plus ib complex number, how to write it, how to write the conjugate, and multiply, how to do division, how to do means all the basic things. Now complex numbers, as I told you, three form will be there. One is the algebraic form, that is the a plus ib format, and other is the trigonometric form, and the last one is the polar form. So all three forms we should know it. So we are going to talk about this trigonometric form, the next one. For that, we discuss about the Argand plane. Ki any complex number is there, a plus ib, z, a plus ib. A plus ib, what you can write? A comma b. So that is the one complex number. And complex number represent as a vector form. We always represent as a vector form. You can just imagine ki any vector we write as a 3i plus 4j. Like that. The same format is there. On x-axis I component and this is the j component. Here we say real part and here imaginary part. Nothing difference is there. Much. These things are the same. So, only thing is that ki in the vector there is a product of vector is there dot and cross. In the complex number there is no dot and cross product. But all other rule will be same. Parallelogram law. All other things and all parallel vector, parallel complex number, anti-parallel vector, anti-parallel complex number. Everything will be same. Only difference will be there. Product of the vector is there. Here product of complex number is not there. It's just multiplication. So if any complex number is there, this is the mod z. This length is mod z. This is the theta. So we'll say z equal to a plus ib. A plus ib. So from here, if this is a comma b, if you draw perpendicular, so easily you can understand this length will be a. This length will be a. Yes or no? And this length will be what? B. But if this is the mod z, so I can say this will be mod z cos theta. A by mod z in this right angle triangle, base divided by this will be cos theta. So A equal to, I can say mod z cos theta. Same way B by mod z equal to sin theta, so B equal to mod z sin theta. Both value I can substitute, so I will get z equal to mod z cos theta plus I into mod z sin theta. Mod z I can take common and I will get cos theta plus I sin theta. This is called as the trigonometric form, or you can say polar form. This form is called as the trigonometric form or polar form. Any complex number can be expressed in this format, where theta is called as the argument of z. And mod z is nothing but modulus of z, length of z, whatever you say. Be clear, mod z is a pure real number. Complex number is only this cos theta plus I sin theta. Understand? So this is mod z into cos theta plus I sin theta. If you think carefully about cos theta plus I sin theta, this is a complex number whose magnitude is 1. Whose magnitude is what? 1. So basically, this represent magnitude and this represent direction. Cos theta plus I sin theta combined represent the direction because its magnitude is 1. It's the same like any vector we always write as a what? Mod A vector into A cap. A cap, do you know? Unit vector. Direction. So the same format. This is a unit complex number. It's a unit, its magnitude is 1. So this is called as the polar form. But there is a condition. Whenever you want to say polar form, if it's a really polar form, so theta must lie between minus pi and plus pi. Be clear, theta cannot be less than minus pi, cannot be greater than pi. Here, theta can be equal to pi, but it cannot be equal to minus pi also. So we will say that this is called as the modulus, condition range of the argument of z. Argument of z is not free hand. It's a limitation is there. Huh. If anybody asks you, z equal to, watch carefully everybody, 2 cos 200 degree plus I sin 200 degree. Is it complex number or not? Yes, it's a complex number. But it's not polar form. Although it's a form of cos theta j to mod z into cos theta plus I sin theta, but since theta is greater than the pi, means greater than 180 degree, so I will not say it's a polar form. But it's a complex number. It's a complex number which if you want to convert in polar form, that you have to do something, which we'll see later how to do. Did you understand the meaning? Complex polar form, if they say that ki, what is the polar, what is the trigonometric form or polar form, means you have, it should be in this form under the condition ki theta should lie between minus pi and plus pi. So here theta should lie between minus pi and plus pi. Okay. So what we understand ki, any complex number depend on two things. One, it's a magnitude. Other, its direction. If none of these two are changing, I will say complex number will not change. If none of these two are not changing, the complex number is not going to change. Now here, I want to tell you something. Imagine one complex number. This is the one complex number, imagine. Carefully watch everybody. This complex number I put with the origin here. Suppose something. Now concentrate on the figure. This complex number is moving. Suppose when it was at origin, that time it's z. When I moved it, now also it's z or something else. Did you understand my question? Let me show you. Suppose this is your Z. And I shown to you, I moved it here. Will it be Z or something else? When I moved it, did I change magnitude? Hello? If I am moving a complex number, suppose this complex number, I am moving it, making it move. Did I change its magnitude? No. I am not increasing length or decreasing length, na? The complex number magnitude doesn't change. Did I change direction? No. Earlier also, whatever the angle it was making with the x-axis, same angle it's making, the direction also I didn't change. These two complex numbers are same. In fact, Z can be, I can create infinite number of copies. I can shift it here. See, still Z. I can shift it here. Still Z. Because see, their direction are same. Their magnitude are same. So, they all these complex number are same. Have you understand the point what I am trying to tell you? So, now question ke raha hai ki sir, then what is the difference? Yes. There is a naming difference. One is called as the position complex number, another is called as the non-position complex number. If tail of any complex number is on origin, called as position complex number. Position complex number, or you can say point complex number. Doesn't mean ki complex number become point, because complex number having the length, it's not a point, it's a name is like that. It's a indicating towards a point. Are you able to understand the point? Huh. If any complex number tail is not on the origin, if tail of a complex number, is not on origin, then it called as non-position complex number. Then it will be called as non-position complex number. Okay, listen me. What actually mean? Suppose, if I say, see, all the geometric problem will be done by using these two logics, so please be careful. Suppose if I say this is the point A, imagine, whose coordinate is anything, let's say 3, 1. This is the point B, whose coordinate is minus 1, 5. Yes, sir. Can you tell me what will be this complex number? This complex number. Let's say Z1. Z1 will be what? Z1 will be what? Coordinate 3, 1. I will say this complex number will be 3 plus I. Yes, sir. Any point complex number you want to get A, B, so that complex number will be written as what? A plus IB. Simple. This coordinate minus 1, 5. So what is this complex number? This complex number, if I want to know. This complex number will be what? What you will say? This Z2. Suppose I say this is the Z2. So Z2 will be equal to what? Minus 1 plus 5i. All of you able to understand. These two are which kind of complex number? Position complex number, because they are starting from origin. If I am asking you, can you tell me any this point can represent by a single complex number, or it can represent by more than one complex number? Single complex number, because only one line can join from origin to this point. More than one line cannot be joined. Now here what I am trying to tell you, listen me. Suppose I say I join A and B, this I join, A and B. Now this is the another complex number. What do you say about this complex number? Let's say Z3. Now listen, stop writing. Z1 when I was writing, I wrote on the head of the complex number. Z2 on the head of complex number. But Z3 I wrote on the line of the complex number. Why? Because the head of this, you cannot say this is the Z3, because this is the Z2 already told. This point is always representing Z2. Yes or no? Carefully understand this point. Suppose I say that this point is some point. Come to this picture. This point, if this complex number is suppose Z1, can I say this is the Z1? No. This is not Z1, because this point complex number, if you want to get, you have to join from origin and then check. This will be Z1. This will be complex number of this point. So whenever any point complex number you want to get it, that point has to be joined from origin, and then only you can tell that that point. So what is this complex number Z3? Some other complex number, and this is non-position complex number. Non-position complex number, because this is not starting from origin. Non-position complex number, whenever you have to write, always write on the line of that. That's why it's sometimes called as a line complex number. Line complex number. Don't get confused, this represents line and this represents point. No, it's just naming. Everyone having length, everyone having the direction. Have you understand the point? Any non-position complex number, non-position complex number complex number is equal to position complex number of head minus position complex number of tail. Simply remember head minus tail. So if anybody asks you what is Z3, so I will say Z3 will be equal to position complex number of the head of Z3. What is that? Z2. Minus position complex number of the tail of the Z3, that is the Z1. This. Is it clear to everybody? Right? इमेजिन। लेट से दिस इज 1.5, लेट से दिस इज 4.1, करेक्ट। तो व्हाट इज दिस कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर, लेट से Z1, लेट से दिस इज Z2, कैन यू टेल मी Z1? Z1 विल बी व्हाट? 1+5i, Z2, दिस इज Z2, 4+i, 1 × i, यस आर नो? इफ आई आस्क यू व्हाट इज दिस कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर, दिस विल बी समथिंग एल्स, लेट से Z3 विल बी व्हाट? Z2 - Z1, बिकॉज हेड माइनस टेल, सो दैट Z3 विल बिकम हाउ मच? Z2 दिस माइनस दिस, तो 3+4i। अरे डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड? Z3 विल बी व्हाट? 3+4i। नाउ लुक, 1+5i रिप्रेजेंटिंग द पोजिशन कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर ऑफ अ पॉइंट 1, 4, दिस इज Z2 रिप्रेजेंटिंग समथिंग रॉन्ग आई डिड आई थिंक 4, no, करेक्ट 4, 4, 1, दिस इज या Z2 एंड Z3 इज द 3+4i, इफ यू थिंक 3+4 इज वेयर, 3, 4 समथिंग, पिक्चर इज नॉट वेरी क्लियर एक्चुअली, समवेयर 3, 4 पॉइंट विल बी देयर। तो बेसिकली 3, 4 पोजिशन वेक्टर विल बी समवेयर एल्स, पोजिशन कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर विल बी समवेयर एल्स, दिस इज द शिफ्टिंग ऑफ दिस कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर हियर। व्हाट आई मीन टू से, इफ आई से दिस कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर, पिक्चर ड्राइंग आई एम डूइंग मिस्टेक्स एक्चुअली, दिस कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर इज, सपोज दिस पॉइंट इज द 2, 3, तो दिस कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर 2+3i। इफ आई आस्क यू व्हाट इज दिस कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर व्हिच इज एग्जैक्टली सेम लेंथ सेम डायरेक्शन, आई विल से दिस इज आल्सो 2+3i। व्हाट इज दिस कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर, दिस इज आल्सो 2+3i। Have you understand the point? Why? Because I'm not changing direction, I'm not changing magnitude. So what is the difference between all these complex numbers? Only one difference, ki this is representing towards a point and this are representing line. And this line, infinite number of position can be happen. Infinite number of non-position complex number can be generated. So every position complex number is unique, but non-position complex number for any complex number can be infinite, because this is just copy paste of all the one particular complex number. Have you understand this particular segment? Is it clear to everybody? This is what meaning used to be there, position complex number and non-position number. By default, always take position complex number. By default, always consider position complex number. By default, you have to consider always position complex number. Suppose somebody say ki 1z equal to 1+i. So it means when I have to draw picture, I will draw always like this position. Ki this is the passing through 1, 1. Yeah. This is the 1, 1. This complex number they are talking. Did you understand? So by default, we always take as a what? Position complex number. हाँ, इफ नॉन पोजिशन इज ऑल्सो कमिंग नो प्रॉब्लम, तो नॉन पोजिशन कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर इज ऑलवेज इक्वल टू हेड माइनस टेल, हेड माइनस टेल मीन्स पोजिशन कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर ऑफ द हेड पॉइंट माइनस पोजिशन कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर ऑफ द टेल पॉइंट, दैट्स व्हाट मीनिंग ऑफ द नॉन पोजिशन कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर यूज टू बी। सो दिस इज व्हाट द मीनिंग ऑफ व्हाई वी से दैट कि दिस टू इज इंपॉर्टेंट, बिकॉज द मैग्नीट्यूड एंड डायरेक्शन, इफ बोथ आर द सेम, कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर विल बी ऑलवेज रिमेन सेम, कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर नेवर चेंज। हाँ, ओनली डिफरेंस व्हाट विल कम, वन विल बी पोजिशन कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर, अदर विल बी नॉन पोजिशन कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर, दैट्स ओनली डिफरेंस यूज्ड टू बी देयर। चलिए, So coming back to our polar form, let's talk about the argument z. But before talking, I'm writing few complex numbers, just concentrate. Suppose I say z equal to 1 plus root 3i. 1 plus root 3i. And z equal to minus 1 minus root 3i. Correct? What is the mod z? Root of a square plus b square 2. And argument z? Tan theta equal to what? B by A. For A plus IB, tan theta always equal to B by A. No confusion here. Theta is called as the argument z. So tan theta in this case will be what? Root 3 by 1. So theta will be what? Pi by 3. Is it clear? Tell me here everybody. Mod z 2. Argument z. Tan theta equal to minus root 3 by minus 1 root 3 pi by 3. Yes or no? Is it not looking something strange? By two complex number we consider, no? Let's say z1, let's say z2. Magnitude and direction both is same. Magnitude of this 2, magnitude of this also 2, argument of this pi by 3, argument of this also pi by 3. Means magnitude and direction both are same. If magnitude and direction both are same, so they should be same complex number or not? But is it same complex number? Any blind person also can say that he is not same. It's a different complex number. But why we are getting same complex number? Means something mistake is happening. Did you understand? Some mistake somewhere is happening. Can you locate the mistake? This is the mistake. In fact, argument z, whenever you have to write it, listen. You have to use this logic. What logic? For argument z, in first quadrant, argument of z will be tan inverse b by a. No doubt, no confusion. If z is in first quadrant, all of you know z is a point. So either it will be in first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. If it's in second quadrant, the argument will be pi minus tan inverse b by mod a. Why mod a, sir? Because a will be negative. I don't want negative here. Third quadrant, minus pi plus tan inverse b by a. Here a and b both are negative, so it will get cancelled. Fourth quadrant, it's a minus tan inverse b by a. B mod b by a. First understand everybody, what actually I'm trying to tell you. Argument of any complex number, if it's above x-axis, if complex number is above x-axis, suppose here, then this will be argument. If it's here, then this will be argument. And this I can say, this angle I can say, if suppose this is the something, this is, see, if you'll think about this one, this is the reflection of this. I'm actually, it's not needed, but just I'm telling you. Imagine, suppose this is minus 3, 2. Think carefully, everybody. What is the image of minus 3, 2? In this quadrant. Image of this will be what? Plus 3, 2. Yes or no? Have you understand? If I ask you, can you get me this angle? You say very simple. This angle will be what? Tan inverse b by a. What is the b here? 2. A is what? 3. So tan inverse 2 by 3. This angle, tan inverse 2 by 3. What is this angle?
same tan inverse 2 by 3.
Did not understand.
Remember, this is a mirror image, na? So this angle theta, so this will be also theta. But argument of this will not be this. Argument of this will be what? This much. And this, what you can write? Pi minus this. That's why I wrote pi minus b inverse tan inverse b by mod a. Did you understand? Is it clear to everybody?
So second quadrant, what do you do always?
Whenever they ask you what is the argument of any complex number, you calculate tan inverse mod of b by a. Tan inverse mod of b by a. I will write in that way only so that you can easily, otherwise you will get confused by removing. Remove this. Everything. Argument here, alpha here, pi minus alpha here, minus pi plus alpha here, minus alpha. Where? Alpha equal to tan inverse mod b by a. That's all. Means ignore all the negative sign. First ignore all the negative sign and calculate alpha. And then check b and a is going to fall in which quadrant. If it's in first quadrant, so alpha itself is the argument. If it's falling in the second quadrant, argument will be pi minus alpha. If it's falling in third quadrant, argument will be minus pi plus alpha. And if it's falling in the fourth quadrant, argument will be minus alpha. I'm sure it's clear to all of you. Did you understand? So this point has to be remembered every time. This is the rule of argument. Anywhere, argument will never face problem if you will apply this. If I ask you, sir, I understand ki alpha, what will be argument here. But what will be argument of the complex number which is here? Zero. Because that is a pure real number. Here argument what? Here argument zero. Here argument plus pi by 2. Here argument pi. Here argument minus pi by 2. Any complex number which will lie on the positive x-axis, argument will be 0. On positive y-axis, argument will be pi by 2. Negative x-axis, argument will be pi. And negative y-axis, argument will be minus pi by 2. Did you understand? Is it clear to everybody? Very quickly, we'll do the questions. Z equal to 1 minus root 3. I have to find out the argument. So what we'll do? First, alpha. Alpha is what? Tan inverse mod b by a. B is what? Minus root 3. A is what? 1. So mod of minus b root 3 by a means root 3. That will become what? Pi by 3. Yes or no? Alpha is pi by 3. Now I decide this in coordinate, how will you write it? 1 comma minus root 3 will fall in which quadrant? 1 comma minus root 3 will fall in which quadrant? Fourth quadrant. Will fall in fourth quadrant. In fourth quadrant, what is the argument? Minus alpha. So I'll say argument Z will be equal to minus pi by 3. Have you understand the point? If suppose somebody say Z equal to minus 1 plus root 3i. Think. Then also alpha will be same thing. Right? Tan inverse mod of b by a. So b positive, a negative, doesn't matter. Alpha will be still pi by 3. But now this is going to fall in which quadrant? It's going to fall in second quadrant. And second quadrant argument Z will be equal to what? Pi minus alpha. Or you can say pi minus pi by 3. Or you can say 2 pi by 3. I'm sure able to understand everybody. If I say Z equal to minus 1 minus root 3i, which I discuss. What is the alpha? Alpha will be tan inverse still mod of minus root 3 by minus 1 minus pi by tan inverse root 3, and that will be pi by 3. Alpha is still pi by 3. But now it's falling in which quadrant? It's falling in the third quadrant. So argument Z will be equal to what? Argument Z will be equal to what? Minus pi plus alpha. Minus pi plus alpha means minus pi plus pi by 3, or you can say minus 2 pi by 3. I'm sure it's clear to everybody. So So argument calculation you should know, because modulus calculation is not a problem. That is very simple, root of a square plus b square. Problem start where, when in the amplitude and argument only, there only problem start. Chaliye. Or some oral question. Z equal to 5. Speak out. Argument Z everybody. Argument Z 0. Why so? It's a pure real number. Pure real number, positive pure real number. So we'll say that key, that will be positive x axis. So argument Z will be 0. Z equal to minus 3. Argument Z. Pure real number. Pure real number, argument will be either 0 or pi. If it's positive, 0. If it's negative, pi. So answer will be what? Pi. If Z equal to 3i. 3i. Pure imaginary. So pure imaginary. Imaginary part is positive or negative, that will decide. 3i will be on the positive y axis. Not 3i. 3 will be positive y axis. Am I right? So argument Z. Pi by 2. Yes or no? If I say Z equal to minus 2i, speak out. Argument Z will be minus pi by 2. I'm sure everybody understood. Any confusion? If Z is pure real, then argument Z will be A option 0, B option pi by 2, C option pi, D option minus pi by 2. What is the answer? Pure real. Pure real non-zero. Pure real non-zero. What is the answer? Why so? Why? It's a pure real number. I didn't mention I'm sorry. I didn't mention that it's a positive pure real or negative pure real. Anything can be happen. If it's a positive, zero. If it's negative, it will be pi. Argument Z equal to what if Z equal to 0? You have to tell, I'm giving you 1 minute time. Answer I should get. Z equal to 0. 0 means 0 plus 0 y. That means neither positive x axis nor positive y axis. It's an origin, no? Answer, speak, speak. Answer must appear. You have to apply your brain. Indeterminate. That's all. Why thinking this much time? Yeah? Basic maths, all of you study. Z equal to 0 means 0 plus 0 y. So argument Z will be equal to what? Means tan inverse. I have to get theta. So tan theta will be what? 0 by 0. And 0 by 0 is what? Indeterminate. If it's an indeterminate, theta will be indeterminate. It cannot be determined. argument of null complex number cannot be determined. Impossible. It can be anything. That's why it's called the indeterminate. Is it clear to everybody? So, we discuss about the argument now. Listen. Suppose let's discuss some questions first. Write in polar form चलिए, let's do it. Z equal to 1 plus I. तो first thing is that we need to represent polar form. We need two things. One is the modulus and another is the argument. तो modulus is very simple. Mod Z will be root 2 here. Argument Z, since it's in the first quadrant, तो alpha itself. भाई 1 comma 1 ना? तो 1 comma 1 means which quadrant? First quadrant. तो alpha will be argument will be alpha and alpha will be what? 10 alpha will be 1 by 1 means alpha equal to pi by 4 means argument z equal to pi by 4. So for this polar form will be root 2 into cos pi by 4 plus I sin pi by 4. I am sure ki everybody got it. Correct? Now, second one. Modulus z will be 3 only. Modulus z 3. Mod of minus 3 by 3. Okay. Now, argument z. Since it's a pure real number and it's a negative x-axis, so I will say argument z will be equal to pi. So this polar form will be written as a 3 into cos pi plus I sin pi. Is it clear? Third one, if you see, it's already form of something into cos theta plus I sin theta. But there is a problem. I cannot say polar form. If I will say polar form, the mod z value should be equal to minus 2. But mod z cannot be negative. Are you getting my problem? See, polar form means what? Mod z into cos theta plus I sin theta format. It's look like this. Because cos theta plus I sin theta is coming. Theta is lying between minus pi and pi. That is also perfectly all right. The problem with this minus sign. What to do? A cos pi by 7 value also, I don't know. That's why I given you something like this. Otherwise, you will calculate value and do the things. So, what exactly has to do this kind of situation? Listen, what I am going to do. This minus I will send inside. carefully. If I will send this side, so this will look minus 2 cos pi by 7 plus I into minus 2 sin pi by 7. Cos pi by 7, anyhow, it's a positive quantity. So this is a negative quantity. This is also negative quantity. Hello, are you able to understand? Alpha, tan alpha, all of you know, b by a. So if b by a, you will do what you will get? Tan pi by 7. So alpha equal to pi by 7, no doubt. But this is falling in which quadrant? In third quadrant. So argument will be what? Minus pi plus alpha. So minus 7 pi plus pi minus 6 pi by 7. Maximum people did not understand what I did. Did you understand what I did? I removed this form. I wrote like this. If I ask you this complex number fall in which quadrant, you will say third quadrant. So I will say calculate alpha. Alpha, you don't know how to calculate. Tan alpha equal to b by a, coefficient of I divided by real part. So that if you do it, you will get tan pi by 7. Because minus 2 get cancelled, and sin pi by 7 by cos pi by 7 will be tan pi by 7. Tan alpha equal to tan pi by 7, so alpha is pi by 7. Since in third quadrant already all of you know minus pi plus alpha is the argument. So minus pi plus pi by 7, so minus 6 pi by 7. So argument we got it, and modulus will be very simple, that there will be 2 only. Modulus will be 2 only. This is square plus this is, some people are crying. Okay, sir, how to? Modulus will be 2 only. Root of this square means 4 cos square pi by 7 plus 4 sin square pi by 7. 4 will come out as a 2, and cos square pi by 7 plus sin square pi by 7 will be 1. So value will be 2 only. So now this polar form will be what? 2 into cos minus 6 pi by 7 plus I sin minus 6 pi by 7. Perfect. Have you understood? How many of you got this answer? Anybody got this answer? Okay. A problem starts somewhere else. Saying fourth one. Very good question. It's already in the form of 5 into cos theta plus I sin theta. Yes, sir. So can't we say polar form? What is the problem that it will be not polar form? This theta. Theta is more than 180. But theta should be less than 180. Yes or no? Listen very, very carefully. One complex number is there. Z. If this complex number I rotated by 2 pi about origin. If I rotate it by 2 pi about origin, will the complex number change? By one complex number is there. Look at this is a complex number, suppose. If I say rotate it by some angle, so this will be new complex number. Why? Because length doesn't change, but direction change. But if I rotate it by 2 pi angle, how much angle? 2 pi. 2 pi angle, if you rotate it, means where, from where it starts, same position it came back. Not getting my point. Are you getting my point? If I will rotate a complex number by some other angle, suppose I rotate it and bring it here like this. Now this is the, if this is a Z, this will not be Z, this will be something Z dash. But if I rotate and like this, I rotate it by 2 pi angle, so it will be remain same Z only or not? Yes or no? So if any complex number rotated full circle, either clockwise or anti-clockwise, complex number will not change. complex number will not change. Are you getting my point? Why I am telling this? In fact, this question solving is not required, this logic. We can do without that also. I will do first without this. I think some of you are not able to understand this logic. We will discuss later that logic. I will tell without that. Cos 200 degree, what you can write? 180 plus 20. This you can write what? 180 plus 20. Equal to 5. Watch it. Cos 180 plus 20 minus cos 20. Yes or no? Plus I sin 20. Now is it polar form? No. Now polar form not there. Because this is the minus cos theta plus I sin theta. I want cos theta plus I sin theta. So what to do? Then restart. I will say this will be minus 5 cos 20 plus I 5 sin 20. Modulus is not a problem. Mod z will be 5. Why? Are by root of this square plus root of this square. So 5 square outside 5 and cos square 20 plus sin square 20 1 to 5. Argument. For argument, I will calculate alpha first. Tan alpha will be what? This divided by this. So minus mod of this. We don't consider minus. So mod of this by mod of this. So how much will become? Tan 20. So alpha will be equal to how much? 20 degree. Is it clear? Alpha will be 20 degree. And now this is going to fall in which quadrant? Second quadrant. It is going to fall in second quadrant. And if it's in the second quadrant, So argument z will be what? Pi minus alpha. I am writing in term of degree. So 180 degree minus alpha means 20 degree. So that will be 160 degree. 160 degree. So your complex polar form will be what? 5 into cos 160 plus I sin 160. Something wrong I did? I don't think so. Something, I don't know why I am feeling I am doing something wrong. Sin 180 plus 20 is how much? It's a minus. That's why, because answer not coming according to the rule. So this will be third quadrant. Third quadrant minus 180 plus 20. This will be minus 60. Minus 160. Minus 160. This will be answer. How many have you got it? Be clear, this kind of question, this way doing is very lengthy. We do by graphical way, it's very easy. Oral answer we can tell. I was about to tell you only, but that it's too early to tell all those things. So that's why I pull my pen back. Is it clear? One question, everybody, give me answer very quickly. Minus 2 into cos 70 degree plus I sin 70 degree. Quickly give me answer. Convert polar form. Over. A very simple question here. Minus 2 cos 70 plus minus 2 sin 70 into I. तो tan अल्फा विल बी व्हाट मॉड ऑफ दिस बाय दिस, तो दैट विल बिकम व्हाट tan 70, तो अल्फा इक्वल टू 70 डिग्री, मॉड z विल बी 2, तो z विल बी इक्वल टू 2 एंड फॉलिंग इन थर्ड क्वाड्रेंट, थर्ड क्वाड्रेंट मींस माइनस 180 प्लस 70. बी क्लियर, यू हैव टू राइट इन टर्म ऑफ रेडियन, आई एम टेलिंग टर्म ऑफ डिग्री जस्ट टू अवॉइड कैलकुलेशन. माइनस 180 प्लस 70 तो माइनस 110 डिग्री, कॉस माइनस 110 डिग्री प्लस आई साइन माइनस 110 डिग्री. हाउ मेनी हैव यू गॉट इट? चलिए, सो दिस विल कंटिन्यू इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. थैंक यू.